to me, they understand, they talk to me.
Part of what makes writing a song for a guy like Randy is his strength is his quietness. I mean, that's who he is. You don't know what he's thinking. But because of that, it doesn't give you a lot of information. I began thinking about, well, there must be a lot going on inside. And at first I was a little uncomfortable with this sort of spooky notion of voices, but I wrote it on acoustic guitar, and I wrote it not as a rock song. I wasn't even thinking a rock song. It was just sort of a dark, trancey. And I was thinking about this guy who's this brooding character who kind of alone in his apartment, that he knows he's got something to contribute, but he's angry at the world, and he wants to get back at all the idiots and all the politicians. And so it was this just trancy, you know, you got your rules and your religion, all designed to keep you safe. And just sort of goes on like that. But then I wanted some sort of emotional release for the chorus. I wanted to feel the kind of the tragedy of this figure. I can't sing that high.
I hear voices in my head. They counsel me, they understand, they talk to me.
So that was the style I wrote it in, and realized, of course, okay, we gotta bump this up on the energy scale, and just made it into a big sort of rock anthem. Which has really worked for him, because he's sort of an enigma kind of guy. You don't know what he's thinking. The more we don't understand, that's when I think we're more interested. So maybe without knowing it, I just lucked into maybe there really are voices talking to him in his head.
We all feel it. We know what an adrenaline rush feels like, and it's just, you know, it's building up. And when your music plays and you walk through, it's like fantasy movie. Millions of people are watching. Go have fun.